Students, now we are going to understand the question number 8 of exercise 1.3. So let us read the statement very carefully. You can see it's a big statement. So basic things are given here, and one question is asked here in A part and second is in B part. So step by step we will move. So don't be in always hurry that to read the statement. So always read the statement carefully. So let us start reading. A cement company earns a profit of rupees 8 per bag of white cement sold. They have two kinds of cement here. It is given in the question. They have grey cement also. They have white cement also. If the company sells white cement, they get a profit of rupees 8. It's a benefit to them. And a loss of rupees 5 per bag of grey cement sold. If they sold the grey cement, then they get a loss of rupees 5. Here it is told to us. Means on white, they'll get profit. On grey, they'll get loss. But 8 rupees profit and 5 rupees loss or every bag. Now, what is asked? The company sells 3000 bags of white cement. Okay, and 5000 bags of grey cement in a month. What is its profit or loss? We need to tell the profit or loss. Now we have to calculate it one by one. So what we can do here is, first of all, profit of one bag of white cement. You know that is given here, that what is the profit of white cement for one bag, that is rupees 8. Now the company sells 3000 bags of white cement. If rupees 8 is the profit for one bag, then profit of selling 3000 bags, which is given 3000 bags of white cement. So what should we do? If for one bag 8 rupees profit, so 3000 bags, we need to multiply 8 into 3000. Then after calculating, 8 threes are 24. So 24,000 rupees. Unit is must to write. So this is the profit, total profit calculated on 3000 bags of white cement. Now it is given that 5000 bags of grey cement also sold in the same month. So we need to calculate the value for that also. So we should write the loss first. Loss of one bag of grey cement. Loss is on grey cement, that you know we have discussed. So what is the loss? Rupees 5. So they sold 5000 bags. So we need to calculate the loss on 5000 bags. So loss of selling, what they sell? Loss of selling 5000 bags of what? Grey cement. So again, if 5 rupees is loss on the one bag, so on 5000 bags, we should multiply rupees 5 into 5000 we should do. So after solving, 5 5s are 25 and the 3 zeros, means they get a loss of 25,000. Now here you can see the profit is 24,000, loss is 25,000. Which one is more here? More is loss. So what we can write? Since profit is less than the loss, so overall it is a loss to the company. The company's total loss. So what will be the total loss to the company is, we should minus the profit from the loss, because the loss is more. So profit minus, sorry, the loss minus profit. What should we write? 25,000 minus rupees 24,000. So rupees 1,000. So what we can say, thus it has a loss of rupees, how much? It is 1000 that we calculated here. So this is the first part of the question which we have solved. That they have asked, is there any profit or loss? So there is total loss of rupees 1000. Now let us read the next part of the question. What they asked? B part. What is the number of white cement bags? Means it is clearly visible here that we need to calculate the number of white cement bags. It must sell It means companies selling actually. To have neither profit nor loss. If the word neither profit nor loss means profit is equals to loss here. So if the number of grey bags sold is 6,400 bags. So grey bags sold means you know that after selling the grey bags there is a loss of rupees 5. So let us start calculating. First of all, we should write loss on selling. You know loss on selling of one bag of what? Of grey cement. So what is the loss for one? As it is given here again I am writing rupees 5. Now we need to calculate it for 6,400 bags. So that we can get the total loss here. The loss on selling of 6,400 bags of what? Of grey cement. So we need to multiply again. So rupees 5 into 6,400. So after solving you can have 32,000. So this is the loss. But it is given that there is neither profit nor loss. So what we can say according to question there profit is equals to loss. According to question it is given. Profit is equals to loss. So profit on selling. What selling? Selling white cement. White cement bags should be. What should be the profit? Because the loss we calculated is 32,000. So profit equals to loss. So means the profit also should be 32,000 rupees. So profit on selling white cement bags should be 32,000 rupees. They should be. So for getting the profit of 32,000 rupees, we need to calculate the number of bags. You can see it is asked, what is the number of white cement bags? Therefore, number of bags of what? Of white cement. How we can calculate? Now think of, if we want to calculate the number of bags, we should have the total profit. The total profit, we know it is equal to the loss. So we should write the total profit here. And if we divide the total profit by profit on each bag, so we can get that number of bags. So profit on each bag, total profit divided by profit on each bag. So the total profit which is given is 32,000 divided by profit on each bag. What was the profit on each bag? So it is given rupees 8. You remember in the question. So it is rupees 8. So after solving, we'll get 4,000 bags. So total number of bags we need to calculate and we have calculated. So this is the solution of the question and this is the answer. I hope you understood the complete 8th question.